wake up and you. I've grown up in my mind, but I'm still. Forever can never be long enough for me.
Story before we start here. Mikayla, it's not been that long ago since you were at our house. Jenny was babysitting you. And I remember you got pretty upset with Jenny and locked yourself in the bathroom. And you didn't come out until your mom came over, which was about an hour and a half. So Ryan, if you have locks in your bathrooms, take them off. But here we are today. You've matured into a beautiful Christian woman. And marrying an outstanding young man. We're all here today to celebrate the relationship of Mikayla and Ryan, to be witnesses and supporters of the commitment they share to one another. They already have a long history together. They have been dating for 4 years, have been going to school together since preschool, and have been engaged for 7 months. They started dating on the 25th, got engaged on the 25th, and today, we'll be married on the 25th. Together, we're a group of the most important people in their lives, and they brought us here to publicly recognize that we've all played some special part in the love they share today. Kayla and Ryan wanted me to thank all of you and to recognize how important each and every one of you are to their relationship. They would also like to recognize all of those who couldn't make it here today, as they are certainly missed, but not forgotten, on this day of celebration. I would also like to express my thanks. It's a great honor for me to be able to do this ceremony for you today. Speaking of important people, there were none more important in influencing their lives than their parents. They have molded and shaped them into who they are today. Marriage gives permanence and structure to a couple's love. It's a way to tell one another that no matter how much you snore or how much Mikayla spends while out shopping, and that may happen, Ryan, that you're still in this together. Marriage is telling the person that you love that you're not going anywhere. And that's a powerful commitment for two people to make to one another. A good marriage must be built on a commitment to God and a commitment to one another. In marriage, the little things, hold hands, it is remembering to say I love you at least once a day. It is never going to sleep angry, and some days that may be difficult. It is standing together and facing the world, and that's not always easy either. It is speaking words of appreciation and demonstrating gratitude in thoughtful ways. It is having the capacity to forgive and forget. It is not only marrying the right partner, but it's being the right partner. In the Bible, 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verses 4 through 8 tells us, love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It is not rude, it is not self-seeking, it is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. Marriage is the gift of God to both man and woman. It is given to provide companionship and intimacy. It is given to make life's difficulties today. It must be renewed again tomorrow and each day after that. After today, legally, you will become husband and wife, but you must still decide every day that comes from now on that you want to be married to one another and that you are going to honor the commitments you made to one another on this day. That you must be committed to working together through not only the good times, but also the difficult times. The Bible is full of verses which truly practice will help ensure the success of your marriage. Before you change vows with one another, I'd like to share a few of them with you. Colossians 3, 12 through 14 teaches us that for your marriage to be successful, you must be merciful, kind, humble, patient, and forgiving of one another. Tie all together, you must daily confess through your words, and more importantly, through your actions, your love for one another. 1 Corinthians 13, 4-8 teaches us that real love concerns far more than the way you feel about one another. It concerns the way you treat one another. If you will always display true biblical love to one another, your marriage will never fail. And finally, Philippians 2, 2-4, we learn the importance of in marriage, the willingness of each person to put the needs of the other first and above your own. If you'll do these things, then you will truly enjoy the blessings of marriage that God intended for you to experience. Mikayla and I now want you to know that as you make your vows to one another, you do so in the presence of God and in the presence of these witnesses. Thus I pray as you do so that you truly understand the seriousness of your commitment today that you're making to one another. Prosperity and ring has become a symbol of the never-ending love that God intends for this home. It is a welcome and constant reminder of God's plan for your marriage. Although these rings are small in size, they are large in significance. Made of precious metal, they remind us that love is neither cheap nor common. Many people think that marriage is a decision they make, but in reality, it is a commitment. As you wear these rings, whether together or apart, you may always be reminded of the commitment and promises made to one another here today. Ryan, if you'll place the ring on the table speaker and repeat after me. I give you this ring
as a symbol of my unending love.
May its presence on your finger
always remind you of my love.
With this ring, I marry you. Place the ring on Ryan's finger. I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my unending love.
May its presence on your finger.
Always remind you of my love.
With this ring, I marry you. Let's have a prayer. God, we thank you for this day. Thank you as we're here today to celebrate. And all of your family, I now pronounce you husband and wife. What God has joined together, let not man separate. Ryan, now kiss your new wife, and as my son Christopher says, don't do it like the French do. It is my great privilege and honor to present to you for the very first time, Mr. and Mrs. Ryan Foltz.
You're so delicious. So soft. Sweet on the tip of my tongue. You taste like sunlight and strawberry bubble gum.
Today. He balances her out, sometimes calms her down. always there for her no matter what. I have no doubt that he's helped her in too many ways to count, and I will continue to be by her side and support her for the rest of her life. Now that Mikayla and Ryan are married, she will still be useful to me and teach me things, I'm sure, but some things are going to change. Like, the clothes might stop being borrowed, but the hair and makeup advice are already shooting through the roof. And one day, I can add legal advice to that for Ryan. She can teach me how to cook, and the signs if your husband's eating it, just to be nicer if he really actually likes it. It'll be really useful when she's a fun aunt and uncle to my kids one day, and in turn, let me spoil hers beyond belief. Also, providing my children with their lifelong best friends, because that's what cousins are made for. She'll also teach me how to deal with living with a boy and all the pet peeves that it brings, and how to, hopefully, hold your temper when the pet peeves happen, and how to say sorry when you can't. Little sisters are a big part of growing up, and that doesn't stop when you get married. But now I get to add a little brother to that, and that's something I really wanted as a little kid. And I couldn't be more excited. I'm so glad you found each other, and I can't wait to keep growing up.
Thank you. remote control. Who spends the most time getting ready to go out? Who will be doing most of the yard work? Who stools the covers more?
She's like,
who says I love you the most in one day? Who talks more? Who's most likely to use up all of the hot water? Who's most likely to get lost? Who's most likely to ask for the directions? Who's most likely to wake up grumpy in the morning? Who's most likely to be running late? Who spends more money? Who has to have caffeine in the morning to function? Who is more stubborn?
Oh, yeah.
Who popped the question? Who is in control of the checkbook? Here's a good one. Who wears the pants of the family? Who will have the biggest say in the kids' names? And last but not least, who's going to be the first to fall asleep tonight? Putting on the show, the cowboy in the back.
Goodness.